Welcome to today's lecture. Today we are going to learn diffusing capacity of lung for carbon monoxide. At the end of the lecture, you should know principle of DLCO, procedure of DLCO, pathophysiological causes of abnormal DLCO. Introduction. DLCO is also known as TLCO. TLCO means transfer factor of lung for carbon monoxide. And DLCO measures the ability of the lung to transfer gas from inhaled air to the red blood cells in pulmonary capillaries. And Mary Cog developed a method to measure the single breath uptake of carbon monoxide in the lungs. Then carbon monoxide is diffusion limited, as it is highly soluble and strongly bind to the hemoglobin. And DLCO measurement reflects the diffusing ability of the alveolar capillary membrane of the lung. And acetylene is perfusion limited, insoluble, that if a small fraction of it diffuses to the capillary blood, no more diffusion will take place, no gradient for diffusion until the capillary blood is replaced by the fresh blood. Let me explain about diffusion limited and perfusion limited. As I said earlier, carbon monoxide is diffusion limited and carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide and acetylene gases are perfusion limited. Let me explain about perfusion limited gases. This is the alveoli, this is the interstitium, this is the pulmonary capillary. And consider, for example, consider acetylene gas in the alveoli, and the partial pressure of acetylene in the alveoli is 20, and partial pressure of acetylene in the capillary blood is 0. When acetylene diffuses to the capillary blood, the partial pressure of acetylene in the capillary blood becomes 20. Now there is no pressure gradient across the alveolar capillary membrane for further diffusion. So no further diffusion occurs. For further diffusion, the capillary blood has to be replaced by the fresh blood. This is because perfusion limited gases achieves equilibrium rapidly. In case of diffusion limited, the diffusion limited gas is carbon monoxide, and assume partial pressure of carbon monoxide inside the alveoli is 10 and in the capillary blood is 0. When carbon monoxide diffuses to the capillary blood, it rapidly binds to hemoglobin. We all know carbon monoxide affinity for hemoglobin is more than 200 times that for oxygen. It rapidly binds to the hemoglobin. So can't contribute to the blood partial pressure of carbon monoxide. So the partial pressure of carbon monoxide in the capillary blood remains 0. The diffusion continues. Here the carbon monoxide never achieves equilibrium by the time the capillary blood blood traverses the pulmonary capillary. In this image you can see perfusion and diffusion limited. In case of perfusion limited, the equilibration is rapid and complete. You can see the rapid equilibration. In case of diffusion limited, the equilibration is slow and it is incomplete. In case of perfusion limited, the rate of gas uptake in the capillary is determined by capillary blood flow. Oxygen is both diffusion and perfusion limited, therefore it is not suitable to measure the diffusing capacity. DLCO measurement is very reliable and sensitive. Next, the capacity of lung to exchange gas across the alveolar capillary interface is determined by structural and functional properties. What are the structural properties? The structural properties includes lung gas volume. diffusing capacity is directly related to the lung volume. Only adequately ventilated and perfused alveoli contribute to gas exchange. Then thickness and area of the alveolar capillary membrane. Thickness of the alveolar capillary membrane. If there is an increased thickness due to interstitial lung disease or pulmonary edema, may result in poor gas exchange. And in surface area of the alveolar capillary membrane, if the available surface area for the gas exchange is less, then it affects the diffusing capacity. And any effects of airway closure, in case of airway obstruction, may result in segmental or lobar collapse, and finally results in volume loss, and it affects directly diffusing capacity. And volume of HB in capillary is supplying the ventilated alveoli. In case of anemia, the hemoglobin level is less, hemoglobin level is low. This results in poor gas exchange. In this image, you can see alveolar capillary membrane. Here you can see the protein-rich fluid inside the alveoli and fluid in the interstitium. And this is the interstitium, this is the fluid-filled alveoli. This fluid-filled alveoli and edematous interstitium results in increased thickness of the alveolar capillary membrane. Because of increased thickness, which leads to poor gas exchange across the membrane. Next, functional properties. The functional properties includes absolute levels of ventilation and perfusion. In some cases, because of inadequate ventilation and perfusion, which results in poor gas exchange. The uniformity of distribution of ventilation relative to the distribution of perfusion. Here, in some cases like segmental and lobar collapse, there is no adequately ventilated alveoli, but the perfusion is adequate. And in some cases like pulmonary embolism and pulmonary hypertension, there is no perfusion, but lung is adequately ventilated. And the composition of alveolar gas. Here the solubility of the gas, more soluble gases diffuses faster. Example, carbon dioxide diffuses much faster than the oxygen. And the concentration and binding properties of the hemoglobin in the alveolar capillaries. If the concentration of hemoglobin is low, then it results in low diffusing capacity. Indication. What are the indications? Restrictive lung diseases. Restrictive lung diseases like interstitial lung diseases, chest wall diseases, neuromuscular diseases, and obstructive lung diseases in COPD, emphysema. Then pulmonary vascular diseases like pulmonary hypertension, pulmonary embolism, prior to lung resection surgery, and disability evaluation. These are the indications. Next, procedure. Preparation. First, we have to prepare the patient. Ask the patient to avoid smoking, alcohol, vigorous exercises, and heavy meal before the test. And there are so many techniques, single breath technique and rebreathing techniques. Single breath technique is widely used. Here the subject exhales to residual volume, then inspires the test gas briskly to the total lung capacity. And next, breath is held for 10 seconds and then exhaled. Here after tidal breathing, subject exhales to residual volume, then inhales to total lung capacity, then he has to hold breath for 10 seconds. After 10 seconds, the patient exhales into the machine until a mid exhalation sample is analyzed for the concentration of carbon monoxide. This is the mid exhalation represents the alveolar gas. This represents the alveolar gas. This represents the alveolar gas. And in the early stages of exhalation, the early phases of exhalation, this is the dead space gas. This is a dead space gas. In a new DLCO machines, we have rapidly responding gas analyzer. It analyzes the carbon monoxide gas in real time. Next, the causes of abnormal DLCO. Here we have low DLCO. What are the causes of low DLCO? The first one, alveolar capillary membrane disease. Here we have interstitial lung disease like a pulmonary fibrosis. It increases the thickness of the alveolar capillary membrane, results in low DLCO. And the pulmonary vascular disease, here we have pulmonary hypertension and pulmonary acute pulmonary embolism. Here, because of thrombus in the pulmonary artery, there is a poor blood supply at the pulmonary capillary bed. There's ventilation is adequate but poor perfusion, results in low DLCO. And the diffuse alveolar congestion in congestive heart failure because of pulmonary edema. Alveoli is filled with fluid, and in acute respiratory distress syndrome, there is a protein-rich fluid in the alveoli. It increases the thickness and poor gas exchange. It results in poor gas exchange. And the diffuse consolidation and the alveolar proteinosis. This also increases the thickness of the alveolar capillary membrane. Then decreased surface area available for diffusion. Here we have a few conditions, pulmonary resection and emphysema, which results in low DLCO. And miscellaneous causes, here we have anemia, Valsalva minor. In anemia, we know the concentration of hemoglobin is low, which results in low DLCO. And Valsalva minor means exhaling against closed glottis. It reduces amount of blood at the capillary blood, results in low DLCO. Next, we have high DLCO. What are the causes of high DLCO? Recruitment of blood in the alveolar capillary bed. Here we have few conditions, supine position. Supine position increases the recruitment of blood in the alveolar capillary bed. Then bronchial asthma, Müller's manner. Müller's manner is opposite to Valsalva manner. Müller's manner means inhaling against the closed glottis. It increases amount of blood at the capillary bed. And hyperdynamic circulation in exercise and fever, it increases the amount of blood supply to the pulmonary capillaries, thereby increases the DLCO. And miscellaneous conditions, in miscellaneous conditions we have polycythemia. Polycythemia means increased number of red blood cells, so high concentration of hemoglobin is available for gas exchange. And alveolar hemorrhage means bleeding into the alveolar spaces of the lung. Here carbon monoxide rapidly binds to the hemoglobin and thereby increases the DLCO.